हेलो नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू डॉक्टर पूनम्स व्लॉग. आवर टुडेज टॉक इन द सेफ मदरहुड वीक वुड बी ऑन व्हाट इज प्री कंसेप्शनल विजिट. नाउ प्री कंसेप्शनल विजिट मीन्स विजिटिंग योर गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट इवन बिफोर यू आर प्रेग्नेंट और इवन बिफोर यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग. ओके, सो व्हाट हैज दिस प्री कंसेप्शनल विजिट गॉट टू डू विथ योर प्रेग्नेंसी एंड हाउ टू गो अबाउट इट, दिस विल बी एक्सप्लेन टू अस बाय डॉक्टर Siddhi Narvekar, who is a gynecologist working in North Goa District Hospital. So, Dr. Siddhi, welcome to my show. And on today's topic, I shall ask you in a question format. Yes. The first question is, what preparation do you need to do when one decides to become pregnant?
So, when a woman decides that she wants to get pregnant, it's important that she is in the best possible health status. So, if you have any kind of health issues, any problems bothering you, so this is a good time to sort out everything so that you are in good health. So, it may be some dental problem, it may be some minor issue like some skin issue, some aches and pains somewhere or whatever it may be. It's a good thing to sort it out before you conceive. Also, it's a good thing to have an ideal body weight when you plan a pregnancy. It will not only help you conceive faster, it will help you avoid so many complications that we do see in pregnancy because of the weight itself. So instead of weight management after you conceive, the best possible time for you is to go into pregnancy with a good weight. And a very important part of this is see a gynecologist or a doctor. This is like a golden opportunity for the doctor to make sure he'll do a general checkup and to make sure that you are fit to have a healthy baby.
Okay, so that is some new concept, but I know about it, but for people it would be a new concept. So now, according to what Dr. Siddhi has said, it is basically having a proper foundation before you build your building. Okay, so that is what is your preconceptional consultation. Now coming to the next question, why is it important to have a preconceptional consultation visit? Isn't it enough to visit a doctor as soon as I come to know that I'm pregnant?
A very good question here. So often the first clue to you that you have conceived will be that you have missed your period. Or maybe you notice that you're having some vomiting sensation or you actually have vomiting. So this will be the first clue to you that you have conceived. But this often will happen when the baby is about, say, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, 6 weeks. Okay, so that often is too late for any issues to be sorted out if you did have an issue to start with. So like the baby's vital organs like the brain, the spinal cord, the heart, all these organs have already started forming or even completed the formation by the time you have even discovered that you have conceived. So that's that golden period, golden window of opportunity, that is 4 weeks to 5 weeks, that is when the baby's brain, the spinal cord finishes formation. That is one time wherein folic acid is very important for the baby's growth and development at that time. So unless you start this supplementation of folic acid before you plan a pregnancy, there's no way that you're going to start this folic acid as soon as you discover that you're pregnant. It's too late at that time. So that is like the most important thing for you. Means this is something which is preventable. This is something which is there in our hands. You can prevent very gross birth defects in your baby if you do have folic acid.
So from this question, there's one more thing that I want to point out to not only the husband and wives or the couple, but even to the elders in the house. Do give the couple, if it is a joint family, not many are joint family, but yes, there are many people who are having seniors at home, give the couple the freedom to go and visit the gynecologist. Because most of the time, if the couple is visiting the gynecologist for the first time, the first thing people will say, any good news? Okay, so couples should go and visit the gynecologist even before the some good news, okay? Yeah, so the next question is, what exactly happens at this preconceptional checkup?
Okay. When you go to meet your gynecologist, what he or she will usually do is ask you if you have any issues to start with. So after sorting out those issues, they will ask you certain questions pertaining to like we call it history. So how are your menstrual periods? How is your reproductive history? Do you have any discharge PV? Are your menses
so
very
discharge PV, can you please explain in common terms?
Like our body sweats. The excess water from our body is given out in the form of sweat. So even our vagina will have some glands. So there will be some discharge, some watery discharge which comes out, which varies in the menstrual period. Okay, and this is all because of hormones. So it is very normal for a woman to have to feel slightly more wetness just before periods and somewhere in between your periods. So just before expecting your menses and in between when the egg is mature and it is ripe. So that is the time during the time of ovulation. These changes are to be expected, but this discharge is never associated with any itching, any pain or any foul smell. So if these three things are not there, then you have nothing to worry. That is the normal female discharge. In the presence of anything of in any of these three features being present, then we may think that it is some infection, and it's a good time to treat it before rather than after pregnancy, because these infections may lead to infertility, they may lead to tubal problems, which they may lead to abortions, they may lead to preterm deliveries too. So these kind of infections, or for that matter any infection in the body, best tackled before pregnancy. So coming back to what exactly is a preconceptional checkup, so after this kind of a detailed history to make sure that you are not suffering from any kind of ailment, we will do a general checkup, which will include maybe your weight checkup, blood pressure, your hemoglobin, some blood tests, as in maybe your hemoglobin to see if you're having any hemoglobin deficiency. Mind you, it is very common in women in general. And so this is a good time to treat the hemoglobin, get it to your normal level so that your pregnancy is healthy. Okay. So some other screening tests we do,
like thyroid and diabetes,
very important. These things also lead to problems during pregnancy in the mother, in the baby also. So any of these things, if we do, if we can detect before pregnancy, nothing like it. So in addition to these tests, if there is any like problem that you the doctor uncovers during the general examination, for example, maybe some heart problem, some lung problem or any other thing like that, then accordingly some extra tests may be suggested.
Also, I think coming to urban population and metro lifestyles, certain things about regarding the drug addictions.
One important, and you know, they say the preventable cause of mental retardation in the baby is alcohol. So, you know, now initially gone are the days when only the men used to, you know, smoke or alcohol. Now it's common, a liberal society. So if you are planning a pregnancy, it's a good idea to cut down on alcohol, avoid alcohol, because as I said, the 4 to 5 weeks period, that is the time the baby's brain is being developed, is forming. So and so throughout also the baby's brain is maturing, so it's completely avoidable in pregnancy. Alcohol is to be avoided.
So why I ask this question is I do get many questions from my followers, you know, who will write to me, please doctor, don't tell my name, but can I still have alcohol? I'm planning to have pregnancy, but I cannot give up with my smoking. I mean, these are the questions which I do get. As Dr. Siddhi rightly said, this is a liberal society. We cannot point out, but you know, at the same time, finally, we are ladies. We are created by the nature for recreating. Okay, so when we are recreating, we have to see that we are in the best possible phase or best possible state of our health. Okay, I think this preconceptional visit, do they have any advice for the husbands also, or it's only for the ladies?
The husband is an equal part of the, you know, the baby making process. So kind of, you know, the babe, the father's weight, the father's attitude. The father smoking also has an impact on the pregnancy. It may be in the form of the semen count and so forth. And also if the smoking, the environment, the smoke, right? So the it's like a couple which goes for a preconceptional visit and for a pregnancy visit nowadays. Gone are the days when it's just the woman's job. It's a couple now.
Okay, so we usually want the couple visiting us, not only the mother. Okay, Dr. Siddhi, what about vaccines? Is in any of this preconceptional visit, do you advise any vaccines and which vaccines?
Yes. So, one important vaccine is rubella vaccine. Now, rubella is a disease which might not have any problem. You might not even notice it if you have it. There'll be some maybe slight fever, some cough and cold, a little bit of rash. But if you do get rubella during the first 3 months of your pregnancy, it can wreak havoc for your baby. So it can have congenital deformities in the baby in the form of heart defects, in the form of blindness,
brain defects,
mental retardation. Yeah. So if all this can be avoided in the form of just one dose of vaccine of rubella, then why not?
Yes.
So again, during preconception period, very important. Nowadays, children will receive this rubella as part of their, childhood immunization. But during our time, it wasn't there in the immunization. That's why rubella vaccine is a must. And in today's scenario, COVID vaccine, of course.
COVID.
So even though now they would be coming with COVID vaccine safe in pregnancy also, but whatever can be done before pregnancy, be it. Do it before.
So like today it is 2nd of July, okay? As of today, on 25th of June, the ICMR has given the guidelines that the vaccine, COVID vaccine, can be used in pregnant women, but the government of India has still not passed this order. So until and unless the government of India passes this order, the vaccine cannot be given in the pregnant woman. So we are just waiting for that good news. And but in whatever side and value, during your preconceptional visit, go ahead, take the vaccine. According to whatever vaccine you are taking, complete both the doses, go ahead with the vaccine, go ahead with the pregnancy. And if by then the new rule comes that you can take the vaccine during pregnancy, then there is no problem, then just go ahead. So this is the importance of the preconceptional visit with a gynecologist. So all those couples who are watching us, please see to it that before you plan your pregnancy, maybe it is your first or second pregnancy, see to it that you visit your gynecologist, take your preconceptional visit, do the steps as told by the gynecologist, follow all those precautions and stay in the best of your health. That's it about the preconceptional visit, and thank you Dr. Siddhi to come on my show and give such a nice enlightening talk about preconceptional visits. Thank you.
Thanks, Pura.